Hello students, so today you are going to learn a new lesson. It is from class 7, acid bases and salts. So this is our name, acid bases and salts. Before starting the lesson, a small activity is given there, so we have to do that activity. And most of the time we are familiar all these substances and we are familiar to all this type of taste. So what is the activity? Taste of some common edible substances. Now, what are the edible substances? Edible substances means the substances which we can eat. Those are called as edible substances. Here is a list of some common edible substances. And the edible substances have different taste. Some have sour taste. Some have bitter taste. Some have sweet taste. And some substances have salty taste. So these are all are the different type of taste. You have to find out which substance have which taste. So here is the number of common substances. All are edible. Now what is the taste of lemon juice? So lemon juice, you know that the lemon juice is sour in taste. Orange juice, what is the taste of orange juice? It is also sour and sweet. Vinegar taste is sour. Curd, sour taste. Tamarind, sour taste. Sugar, we know it is very sweet in taste. Common salt, it is salty in taste. Amla, so sometimes it's bitter also. Baking soda, bitter in taste. Sweet and sour taste, grapes has. Then unripe mango means raw mango, which are sour in taste. And glucose, also sweet in the taste. So these are the common substances which are having this type of taste. Now next point is acids. Now here you are going to learn what is acid, because our lesson name is acid, bases and salts. So the first point is acid. So there may be question in your mind, what is acid? So acids are substances which have sour taste. Acids are nothing but they are substances. The substances which are having sour taste, these substances are acidic in nature. So the substances which are sour in taste, like curd, lemon juice, they are having sour taste. So like these substances, when they are sour in taste, those are acidic in nature and they contain some type of acid in it. Now here are the some list. Here is some list of some substances. Number one, vinegar. Vinegar is also called as acetic acid. So what is the taste of vinegar here? Vinegar, its name is acetic acid. So what type of acid vinegar contains? Vinegar contains acetic acid. Now in some substances, there are some different type of acid. So we will see the names of the acid. We will learn now. Ant sting, when a red ant bite to our skin, we have some irritation. Small kid starts crying, because when ant bite to the small kids, this area or any area of the skin becomes red in the nature. And when it becomes red, it starts some irritation and small kid starts crying. So what type of acid ant sting has? Formic acid. Citrus fruits like lemon, oranges, they are having citric acid. Curd also contains acid, lactic acid. Spinach has oxalic acid. Amla has ascorbic acid. Tamarind, grapes, unripe mangoes, all these are having tartaric acid. It's very simple. Tamarind, its spelling starts from T. And it's what type of acid it contains? That acid spelling also starts from T. So T for tamarind and T for tartaric acid. So like this acids are available and they are present in different type of substances. Next is base. Before starting the base, once again we will revise for the acid. Acids are nothing but these are the substances which are sour in taste. But now bitter. So now base. So what is mean by base? Here we can understand. Base are also some substances, but they have bitter taste. Again, a simple hint, all of you. This base spelling starts from B, and bitter spelling also starts from B. So base has a bitter taste. B and B, which have soapy touch. Again, one more feature of the base is bases are in soapy touch, or they are having the nature of soapy touch. These substances are basic in nature. So the substances which are bitter in taste and the substances which are bitter in taste and soapy on touch, that type of substances are called as bases. Here some example of bases are given: lime water, which has the base calcium hydroxide. So in the lime water, what type of base is present? Calcium hydroxide. Window cleaner. If you have window cleaner at your home, you can check the bottle. You can see on the bottle there are some ingredients written on it. Maybe you can see ammonium hydroxide. So the substance, or the liquid which we use to clean our windows, so that window cleaner, it contains one base, and that base is ammonium hydroxide. Soap which we use for our bathing, and which we use to clean our body. Otherwise, some soaps which we use to clean our clothes, that type of soap, they contains base. So what type of base this soap has? Sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. So these are the names of the base. Milk of magnesia. Now milk of magnesia is the substance, and this milk of magnesia contains one base, and its name is magnesium hydroxide. So in this way, these are the substances and these are the name of base. Generally, here I would like to tell to all of you the milk of magnesia. When we feel acidity, at that time we take some tablets from the doctor, maybe Omex or another Pandi. So all type of this type of tablets which we get to relieve our acidity, those contains milk of magnesia. Actually, to relieve the acidity, we have to take some base. So that base, when we take from the tablet, so those tablets are containing the base which is which can nullify the acidity, or which can neutralize the acidity, and we get relief. Further, we will see all those points. Next point is neutral substances. Now you have seen what is base, what is acid. Now neutral substances. Now what is meant by neutral, or what are the neutral substances? Substances which are neither acidic nor basic in the nature are called as neutral substances. If the substance is acid, in acidic nature, then the substance is acid. If the substance is in basic nature, then the substance is basic. But here, the substances which are neither acidic nor basic, those are called as neutral substances. Now, which are those? For example, sugar solution, salt solution, or distilled water solution. These solutions are the examples of neutral solution. If you dissolve sugar in the water, you get sweet water, that is sugar solution. If you take a glass of water and if you add salt in the water, then that solution will be salt solution and distilled water solution. So these two type of solutions are neither acidic nor basic. So these are called as neutral solutions or neutral substances. Now indicators. What is meant by indicator? Indicator is nothing but it is also one type of substance. Now, what type of substance indicator is? Substances which change their color in acidic and basic solutions are called as indicators. So this indicator help us to identify whether a given solution is acidic or basic in the nature. Now the substances which change their color, these indicators are changing their color in the acidic solution or in the basic solution. So there are different type of indicators. Some indicators are naturally found and some indicators are synthetic. Synthetic indicator means artificial indicators, means man-made indicators. Now here you can see litmus, turmeric, China rose petals. So these are the some naturally occurring indicators. So these are indicators, these are present in the nature, so these are called as naturally occurring indicator. But if you see methyl orange and phenolphthalein, these two type of indicators are man-made indicators, synthetic indicators or artificial indicators. But now in our book, these type of indicators are given, only natural indicators are given. Litmus, it is available in solution also, it is available in paper form also, red litmus paper and blue litmus paper. Otherwise red litmus solution or blue litmus solution. This litmus obtained from one plant and that plant name is lichen. Turmeric, we know the turmeric we use in our kitchen for many for making the vegetables. Sometimes we drink turmeric milk also for our health. And China rose petals, it is also one type of plant. Now next point is, we will take information about natural indicators, and that is litmus. So as I told to all of you, natural indicator means litmus. So litmus as indicator, litmus is a natural indicator. Litmus is a natural indicator. Now what is information about litmus? It's a natural indicator. And from where it is obtained? It is obtained from the lichen plants. Now it is available in the form of solution, as I told to you, and as a blue litmus solution and red litmus solution, or as a strip, means in paper format. Paper strips of paper as blue litmus paper and red litmus paper or red litmus solution. Now here you can understand that this plant is a lichen plant. If you see, this one is lichen plant. This plant, from this plant indicator is made, that is this plant gives us litmus indicator, and this litmus indicator is available in solution format, means in liquid and paper, or in strip format. In distilled water, its color is purple. So in distilled water, litmus color is purple. In distilled water, its color is purple. In acidic solution, on it turns red. And in basic solution, it turns blue. So, in acidic solution, litmus paper turns red. In basic solution, it turns blue. Again, B for base and here B for blue. As I told you, base, its taste is bitter. Again, its spelling starts from B. So, B for base, B for bitter, and B for blue. So BBB. It is a small hint to all of you for the remembering all these points. So here acid, base and the indicators. So first you have learned about litmus indicators. Next point is, here some effect of litmus paper on different solution. This is the activity from the book. So here some taste of solutions and how it affect on it, it is given. So once again I will tell to all of you that in the acid, litmus paper turns red in color. If you take blue litmus paper, so blue litmus paper turns red, and red litmus paper do not show any of change. In the basic solution, red litmus paper turns blue, but blue litmus paper remains blue. like this way the activity is given in our book. So with the some solutions we have to check litmus with the litmus paper whether the given solution is acidic or basic in the nature. So litmus paper is an indicator which helps to identify whether the solution is acidic or basic in the nature. Another indicator is turmeric indicator. Now turmeric is a second natural indicator. And what is the turmeric? Turmeric is available everywhere, easily it is available. And turmeric is a natural indicator obtained from the turmeric. Now turmeric plant, from the turmeric plant the turmeric indicator is obtained and that can be used as a turmeric solution. Turmeric indicator can be used as in the form of solution, in the form of liquid or turmeric paper. So turmeric paper is also available in the market in acidic solution and in neutral solution. Turmeric paper turns yellow, means it remains yellow as it is. There is no change in the acid or neutral solution. But when you dip turmeric paper in basic solution, immediately the basic solution turns into bright red. If you are familiar with the example, when you go in hotels, when you take your lunch or dinner, at that time suppose some curry stains, if you have on your white cloth, and when your mother start washing it afterwards, when she apply soap on it, that turmeric stain immediately turns into bright red, because turmeric show bright red color in the basic solution. But in acidic solution or in neutral solution it shows only yellow color. But again there is a point, how can we identify whether the solution is acidic or neutral? If you have only two solutions, acidic or neutral, so with the help of this turmeric paper, how can we identify whether the solution is acidic or neutral? For that purpose, you have to dip that litmus paper into base. So when you will take any base, soap solution you can take, and in the soap solution if you dip litmus paper, so this part of the litmus paper turns red, bright red, and same piece of paper if you dip in the acid, then it turns yellow. And if there is no change, if it remains as it is, then that solution is neutral. So this is the difference. So by this we can identify whether the solution is acidic or neutral, because the red strip which is in base, if you dip in the neutral, it can remain as it is. So you can easily understand that is a neutral solution. And immediately when you dip in the acid, immediately it turns into yellow color. So that red strip will turn into yellow color, so that solution can be acidic in the nature. So here some examples are given. Here you can see some test solution, lemon juice. If you have turmeric solution, yellow. That turmeric paper turns yellow. So that remark is the lemon juice is acidic in nature. Orange juice. So when you dip turmeric paper in the orange juice, it also shows yellow color. Vinegar, it is also acid, it also shows yellow color of the turmeric paper. Now milk of magnesia, baking soda, lime water, all these can show bright red color, because all are the bases. And here sugar solution, common salt, there is no change because it is neutral solution. The next point is China rose an indicator. Now you have learned about litmus paper as an indicator, as well as turmeric as an indicator, and this is a China rose as an indicator. So China rose is also a natural indicator because we get it from the plant. China rose is a natural indicator obtained from the petals of China rose. From where it is obtained? From the petals of China rose. China rose flower. So if you take the China rose flower and from the petals of the China rose flower, when you crush the China rose petals, you get the solution. It It is used as China rose solution. In acidic solution, it turns dark pink or magenta, and in basic solution.